Hello everybody. Last time we looked at the charts to measure the sales, the operating profit and the margin, and they were all vertical oriented. But of course we can do the same, but then make, instead of a column chart, a bar chart from it. And that's what we're going to do in the cost chart. So let's have a look in Excel how we're going to do that. So here we are in our file, and I immediately went to the cost sheet. And here I have all the information, all the cost elements, and the actual value, and the budget value. And we're going to create a chart from that. Yeah, there we are. And then I need to do the trick with the control button. There we are. So I've selected the data, I've selected the cost elements, the categories, and I've selected the numbers, and I'm going to say insert bar chart to the bar. And there we are. And we know from the last time that the trick we have to do is we select the actual range, we right mouse click, and we're going to format the data series, and we're going to put it on the secondary axis. So there we are. And we have to play a little bit with the gap width, and we're going to change this one to 200%. And now I want to select also the other series, but I have to be very careful, so I don't like that. Luckily, I also can select over here a different data series. So I'm going to series 2. And I will change the value over here to 50. And this is kind of okay, but of course we have the same scaling problem. So we're going to format the axis a little bit. And in this case, I want to be a hard-coded maximum of 2 million. And I'm going to do the same over here. So, then I don't need this one. And now I have still one problem, is that the data is not sorted correctly. The easiest way to do that is sort it over here. There are other ways to do it, but this will do the trick. We're going to sort it on column C, the actuals. And now it's ranked from high to low. I like that, to have that in the chart. Get rid of the title. Get rid of the legends, get rid of the grid lines. Also, I want to change these big numbers. So we're going to change the number format again. And I want to have that in thousands, so a single comma should do the trick. There we are. And then we have to adjust the format, but then I have to select the chart area. I also can change the format over here, and we want to be that to be 2.15 and or well known 2.27. And then we should get rid of any fill that's left there. No border, no fill. We will, oh, and we still have a very ugly color that we will change with this color to keep it consistent. There we are, and we're almost ready. We go back to our dashboard. And we will put it in over here. And these are costs. And that should be a little bit larger font, 20. There we are. Get rid of this. And another chart filled. So the cost graph is also there. Now let's have a look what we will see in the next video. In the next video, we're leaving the charts for a moment behind and we're going to look at a full profit and loss statement in a table. And that's going to be interesting, I promise you. See you then.